In 2012, could Ohio blow the lid off the GOP presidential race? Look at this new poll from Quinnipiac University showing Rick Santorum now leading Mitt Romney by 7 points among Republicans most likely to vote in the March 6th primary. Another former frontrunner, Newt Gingrich, is now trailing Santorum by 16 points. Ohio is the richest prize on Super Tuesday, and we could again be the key to winning the White House in November. So tonight, News 5's John London shows how local supporters are trying to boost their candidates.
The trunks, filled with Republican primary fever, are opening all across the state this week. The signs of grand old primary are popping up all over. Tara Menkhouse has her grassroots art ready to go for this weekend. She's all for Paul, the phone bank suggesting it's wide open.
Most people really don't know. The most common response is they don't know who they're voting for.
Nearby, a Tea Party trio is stepping up the planning for a possible Santorum rally in early March. Their surging star makes his inaugural Ohio campaign appearance in 48 hours, first in Warren County, then Brown.
He's family values. He's freedom. He understands the budget.
Santorum's momentum removes any assumptions the Romney camp might have carried into March.
Romney campaign expected this. I think it's positive that we're not just handing it to somebody that's been waiting in line.
Romney, whose last appearance in this area was 4 months ago, will be in Cincinnati on Monday for a private fundraiser. So far, no public event is scheduled. Nothing like the recent Gingrich gathering at Price Hill Chili. Whether he'll be back between now and March 6th is not yet known. The goal of getting their stars aligned with a local rally is complicated by schedules, other primaries, fundraising. The Santorum folks may have a better idea after meeting with his national people in Columbus on Saturday. An effort to attract Ron Paul to UC is underway. Those campaigns have a lot of loading and unloading ahead of them in the next 20 days. In Milford, John London, News 5.